Welcome to your season of hope. Welcome, welcome, welcome to yet another day and yet another episode of Hope with me, Pastor Paul John. And hey, today, first and foremost, let me thank you all. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your participation and sending us that feedback both online and through different avenues, how this program is truly being a blessing into your life. My friend, you know what to do. Call somebody, tell them hope is on, share this to somebody. And I'm telling you, today's program is going to be wonderful. Because I know what the Lord has in store for you. So without any further delay, let's go right into today's program. Welcome to your season of hope. Well, hallelujah, let's go into our Bible, Psalms chapter number 8, and you are in for an exciting program today. I'm telling you, get ready, get ready, get ready. God is about to blow your mind today as you're going to see how God is interested in every area of your life. And He is the one that has gifted you with talents for you to use that for His glory. Let's read in Psalms chapter number 8. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Who have set your glory above the heavens, and out of the mouth of babes and nursing infants you have ordained strength because of your enemies, that you may silence the enemy and the avenger. And in verse 3 he says, when I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained, what is man that you are mindful of him? Or the son of man that you visit with him. For you have made him a little lower than the angels, and you have crowned him with glory and honor. You have made him to have dominion over the works of your hand. You have put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, for from the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea that pass through the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Friends, today I have with me Marti Iluz. She was here with her husband last week. And today I've asked if she can stay back and just share from her heart as to how the Lord is using her, especially in the area of art and creativity. Marti, welcome.
Thank you.
I'm still thinking of that powerful testimony both you and your husband shared last week while you were here, and I am of the belief that God doesn't do anything without purpose.
Amen. Amen.
Before He starts a thing, He has already completed it,
mm-hmm.
and then He starts it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, just a little bit that I've read about you and what you've shared from your life. I see that you are involved in painting and artwork. So, and I saw on your website, what is your website?
It's martiiluzart.com.
martiiluzart.com.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's on the screen now, so friends, go and visit that. And I like what you wrote there about, I am a creature,
mm-hmm.
I am created, I'm a creature that is created,
mm-hmm.
I'm a creature that is created with creativity. I just love that. So, share.
Yes. You know, to me as an artist, to be able to create,
mm-hmm.
God gave each human being that ability to create, whether mm-hmm. it is to cook a meal, mm. whether it is to raise children, mm. whether it is to have a conversation, everything is, we all have that. And to me, that is just the most amazing thing that, you know, who of us, we as people can create something. We can create a cell phone that can function. It's great. But it cannot create another phone. It cannot create another anything. You know, seeds have got it in them to become another tree, like after its kind, or animals. But it's only human beings who have got this creativity that God has, that we can create something new, that we can bring things from the spiritual world and we can translate it and use it as a language to speak.
Wow. That's you just said about creativity, and with parenting, it does take a lot of creativity to parent.
Oh, yeah.
It does take. And I guess, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, I know that you're a parent of three children, and so am I. My wife and I, we have three children, and many of our viewers. I think that some of the time we try to parent everybody the same way.
Yes.
And maybe, can that be a lack of creativity? I don't know.
You know, I think the problem is that our culture have taught us that creativity is only if you can sing, if you can play a musical instrument, if you can paint. That's creativity. And it kind of ends there. And I think we miss out that the whole of life, every morning that you wake up, you know, God gives us, he inspires us, he gives us his word. We can do something new every day. I homeschooled my kids for 10 years. And so you have to be even more creative to keep them there. And that's really what the Lord taught me. And sometimes I got a little, you know, maybe frustrated because I couldn't paint. I left my art for many, many years. But then the Lord taught me that, you know, this is your creation now. This is your work. These three kids are what I gave you. You better do your best and dig deep because I'm trusting you with them. And so that was the focus of my life, was to really teach them God's ways and to raise them up with learning to think for themselves. They don't have to think like the culture. They shouldn't think like the world. They should really trust God and think for themselves.
You know, thinking about, I just want to touch on something here, and I want to have your take on it, because, you know, I went to a school in India, and I guess you did the same in South Africa. Now that you said that you homeschooled your children, but in school, you know, they put these exams, which is, I'm sure they're, you know, they are really, you need to have those. Yeah. But many times we allow those grades to define who we are.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Maybe I was bad at math, but I might have been a great musician, you know. Or might have been a great entrepreneur, or say whatever. Somehow I feel that even in our, I gotta be careful when I say this, even in our church community, we are so boxed.
Yes.
How can we encourage our people, you know, both in Africa and India, we have majority of the population is between 15 and 40. So how do we encourage our young people to explore that avenue, which they might be talented with?
Yes, yes. You know, I think it really has a lot to do with parenting. I think that is where it begins. I think it has a lot to do with who we as Christians are in our relationship with God, because the more that we grow and mature in our relationship with God, the more we understand that we are, that he really made each one of us unique, and he really formed us in our mother's wombs uniquely. And if we understand that as parents, then we will see our children like that, and not just see them as a nuisance or as a stage that has to get past so that we can do our own thing. That really becomes our focus, and then you start pouring into your children. Why I homeschooled is exactly for that reason, because you come out as a product. I've been looking square or round or triangular, but you come kind of out as that product, and you really have to work hard to break through this, where is where real creativity comes in. So with homeschooling, why I loved it is because you can really tailor make it. You can see how your children learn. Like you say, in school, it is created for kids who like books, who learn through reading, through, you know, my kids were not really like that. They were very audible readers. I read a lot to them, and that's how they retained, you know, knowledge and information, and challenged them. I think our children also don't get challenged enough. I think kids are bored today. Everything gets done for them. Everything is laid out for them. Each one have got their little entertainment center.
Yeah. You know, when I went to school, even they would, you know, the teachers would, they would ask a question and they would ask us to go to our textbooks and they will tell you the answer. The answer is in the second paragraph of page 36, the second line to the fifth line. So what I did was just memorize it.
Yes, of course. And 5 minutes later, you forgot all about it.
Oh, you bet.
You're not educated in school. You're schooled in school.
Say that again. Say that again, please. We are not what?
We're not being educated in schools. We're being schooled in schools.
I'm sorry to say, but I guess that's the same thing we've been doing in church as well. We've been churched in church.
Yes.
Not being informed and illuminated with the word of God that can bring revelation.
Amen. Amen. Huh? And we've been taught to become lazy. Mark Twain actually said, I never let my schooling get in the way of my education.
Ooh.
And I think in the church, probably the same thing happens. We sit, people come to church, we open our mouths wide and we swallow. And then we carry on with life. And if there is not a real relationship, if you don't like any relationship, a relationship between a husband and a wife, parents and children, if you don't invest in that relationship, if you don't take it seriously and ask questions and challenge it, see if it's going to hold. You can't build a bridge and not jump on it. You need to see if it's going to hold. And our faith is not being tested.
That's right. And that's why when it is being tested, several of us turn our backs on our faith.
Exactly.
And a lot of young people struggle with that.
Yes.
I myself, and I have a daughter, I have children in that age today, and I find it really, these questions are really valid.
Yes.
And But back again to this aspect of, you know, helping our young people, or no matter, just not people. Let's not just say young people. People, because we are all created in the image and likeness of God. Several might be watching today that they might have thought that their grade from 1969 is what they are. And I want you to share something today that can set people free from that so that they can get this vitality back.
Amen.
Inspiration to do something back.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Yes. The world has made us a very narrow passage in which to qualify as worthy human beings. And either you've got to have a degree, you've got to be educated in academics, you've got to be either a pastor or a lawyer, you've got to be somebody with a title.
Mm-hmm.
And yet in the Word of God, we are taught that we are all one body and we all have a role to play.
Yes.
And what we do is we push the things of our heart, how the Lord created us with our talents and gifts, we push that away as almost like a guilty sin, like a little, it's not really God's way. God's way, we need to all be serious. We all need to look like that, speak like that. You understand? Instead of using our gift, if you've got a gift of music, a gift of art, a gift of building things, use that to worship God. Because today we've accepted that so many Christian artists, for instance, they think they are first artists who happen to be Christians. They are not first Christians who happen to be artists. And that is the language. So my art to me is the language by which I can communicate to others what the Lord is teaching me in my life. And so the same thing, whether you are an admin person, do the same thing. We are called to do everything as unto the Lord.
We are called
to have a spirit of excellence. If you clean toilets, let that be the cleanest toilets ever because you're going to be blessing somebody. But we have lost that, and we are all, I suppose, guilty in some way of allowing that to happen.
Wow. That's this is where I feel that most of us need to revisit again.
Yes.
And to you know, go. Most of us Christians, if we are just going to talk about Christians, about us as believers in the body of Christ, regardless of where we are, do you think, Marti, that this will, that allowing ourselves to walk that path and explore who God really created us to be, could it be a possible solution for the different kinds of mental illnesses that we are facing today, and, you know?
Of course.
Depression
course,
and...
Of course. Why do people feel lost and fearful? Because I think there's nobody in control.
Hmm.
And what you read in Psalm 8, the heavens declare the glory of God.
Yes.
We need to remember who God is.
Hmm.
We need to remember how great He is. Mm. You know, if we focus so on the human being and saying, what is my gifts? What, who am I supposed to be? We become all fearful. You know, oh, what if I can't do that? Instead of saying, wow, remember who God is. Mm. He created all of this. Mm. He's in control of every single aspect of life.
Mm.
You know, that gives me personally so much freedom.
Mm.
It makes me secure in myself.
Yeah.
It
yeah.
makes me, you know what, for 5 years I was cleaning toilets and keeping a house and washing the feet of the saints. I wasn't doing what I loved doing, creating and painting, but I loved that too because it allowed me an opportunity to give other saints the chance to really grow and to really give outing to, you know, to evangelize, to speak to people, to grow in God. Yeah. So, yes, I think to me that is the biggest thing. We have lost the fear of the Lord in the church today.
Wow. I'm also thinking of this other thing. If we can just, we just have a few more minutes here with you, and I just want to bring this back again to where we started with about being creative, you know. And do you remember this blind man Bartimaeus in the Gospel of Mark? Mm-hmm. Even in my Bible, it'll say blind Bartimaeus. You know, when I read there from 12, 10 and verse 46 and forwards there, yes, he was blind. Yes.
Mm.
And that blindness caused him to be rejected by his parents and put him outside township, you know, outside the town. Everybody around him knew he was blind. But he refused to have his defect of blindness control his
Amen.
Destiny.
Amen. Yes.
He heard. His ears were working.
Yes.
So when he heard that Jesus was passing, right?
Yes. Amen.
He was blind, yeah.
Amen. Amen.
His mouth was working.
Yes. Yes.
So he cried out.
Yes.
He cried out louder than the other voices.
Amen.
And then his feet were working.
Mm.
So I feel that if we could use what's working, we will get rid of what's not working.
Amen. Amen. Absolutely. Huh? Absolutely. Yes. Yeah.
Before we close here with you, I want you to take a few minutes, 2 minutes, just encourage what should people do? How can they, you know, where to start? Mm. If they got a gift in any area of life, where to start?
Mm.
And how to proceed, please. Mm. Look into the camera and just go ahead.
You know, the Apostle Paul said to Timothy, stir up the gift that is in you.
Mm.
The Lord gives gifts to people, to all of us. All of us have a gift, each one of us. And whatever it may be encouragement. Mm. It may be the gift of listening.
Mm.
Stir up that gift because God has created you to take a very important part. Every part in the body is important. We all know that. If there's one cell that goes random, cancer cell, it spoils the whole body.
That's right.
So we might just be a small little part. We may not feel so important, but it's the small little parts that hold the body together. And so let us not let our what the world has put in us, that there are important people and not important people. Let that not rule us, but let us really go before the Lord and bring everything before the Lord and lift up His name, because through that, through our conduct, through our lives, through the way that we do things and say things, we preach the gospel of Jesus, and that is the most important. It is, there is a lost world out there. There's a world that is just going. It's slipping away further and further every minute. Mm. And so if we do not start truly coming before the Lord and stop criticizing also, stop criticizing the church. This is the bride of Christ.
Yes, yes.
And He died for her. Mm. We need to start really loving one another. We need to really start humbling ourselves again before the Lord. And we need to be renewed and repent as believers. Yeah. I believe it's the time.
Wow. Hallelujah. And embrace each other.
Amen.
Everybody got an issue.
Amen.
Everybody watching got an issue. Even your preachers got an issue. That's why everybody needs a Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Marti, thank you.
Thank
you so friends,
much.
I want you to go, just go into her website. She's got great blogs as well. You'd see some of her painting. It's Marti Iluz Arts.
Yes.
.com. It's on the screen. Go pay a visit, and I'm sure you'll be blessed by her work and even receive encouragement for what God has called you to do. God bless you. Wow. Hallelujah. Friends, so many things Marti shared today. So many things. And I just, especially when it comes to parenting, if I may take some time and talk to us as parents, I know that the stress of life, the pressures of life really become a burden. And when, especially, none of us are perfect. I know every single parent. I'm a parent myself. And I know that we have all failed in some areas, but you know what? God brings hope. And you can see that in your child. You are the best parent your child can have. So, hey, speak words of hope, words that bring in and sow in that talent and the gift that God has on your child, on your son, on your daughter. No son, no daughter is useless or worthless. They are created in the image and likeness of God. I hope you've been blessed by today's program. I hope that you can even go back and check out some of Marti's artwork and the beautiful blog that she has. Friends, especially if you are young today, in the age group of 15 to 40, get ready. God has a fantastic future for you. When you know that you are His instrument on planet Earth to reveal His glory through every sphere of life. God bless you. Let's pray before we leave. And you know that I don't close any broadcast without asking us to receive the Lord. So would you pray with me? Receive the Lord. Say, Father, come into my heart. Let's pray this. Heavenly Father, I come to you in Jesus' name. Wash me of my sin. Cleanse me. Forgive me of all my sins. I receive you into my life. I boldly confess that Jesus is Lord. Amen and amen. If you prayed that prayer, you're a member, you're an heir, and a joint heir in God's family. God bless you, and I'll see you again next week.